Consider the polynomials. P of x is equal to x to the 6th minus x to the 5th minus x to the 3rd minus x squared minus x. And Q of x is equal to x to the 4th minus x to the 3rd minus x squared minus 1. Given that z1, z2, and z3 and z4 are the roots of Q of x equals 0, find P of z1 plus P of z2 plus P of z3 plus P of z4. So a good place to start, and you might have already realized this, that if these guys are the roots of Q of x equals 0, that means that Q of z1 is equal to Q of z2, which is equal to Q of z3, which is equal to Q of z4, which is equal to 0. They're the roots. They're solutions to this equation here. Now, given that, and we want to evaluate P of z1 plus P of z2, it seems like it would be useful if we can express P of x in terms of Q of x, because then when we evaluate these, the parts that would be Q of z1 or z2 or whatever would evaluate to 0. So let's try to do that over there. So the first thing I'm going to try to do, I'm going to try to express these higher degree terms in terms of Q of x. And to do that, if I multiply Q of x times x squared, this x to the 4th will become an x to the 6th, this x to the 3rd will become an x to the 5th. It won't be exact, but we might be able to adjust a little bit to get something right over here. So let's try to do that. So let's think a little bit about what x squared times Q of x is going to look like. That's going to be x squared times x to the 4th, that's x to the 6th, minus x to the 5th, minus x to the 4th, minus x squared. Just multiplied all of these terms times x squared. Now, that isn't exactly what we have up here for P of x. In order to get it exact, we need to, what are we going to have to do? Let's see. We don't have an x to the 4th up here, so we're going to have to get rid of this x to the 4th. So let's add x to the 4th to both sides. So let's add x to the 4th to both sides of this equation. So that would get rid of an x to the 4th. And let's see, we have no x to the 3rd here. We do have an x to the 3rd there. So let's subtract x to the 3rd from both sides of this equation. So I'm going to subtract x to the 3rd from both sides of this equation. And then we do have a negative x squared. We do have a negative x squared over here. And then we have a negative x here. I don't see a negative x over here, so let's subtract a negative x from both sides. So negative x. This is all for the left-hand side. And so we're left with the left-hand side of the equation. We get x squared times q of x, x squared times q of x, plus x to the 4th, plus x to the 4th minus x to the 3rd minus x is equal to, what's this equal to? It's equal to x to the 6th. Well, I didn't want to use that shade of purple. Let me use a blue one. It's equal to x to the 6th minus x to the 5th. These guys cancel out. Minus x to the 3rd minus x to the 3rd minus x squared minus x squared. And then you have a minus x there. Minus x, which is exactly, this is, we were actually able to completely construct P of x. This is equal to P of x. It's equal to all of this business on the left-hand side. Now, we could just stop there, but it looks, this part right here looks tantalizingly close to Q of x as well. In fact, it is, that part right there, using the exact same process, would be Q of x, just the green part, it's Q of x, with these things gotten rid of. So we would have to add an x squared. So it's q of x plus x squared plus 1. Right? If you start with q of x, you add an x squared, you add a 1, these two will go away. You just have an x to the 4th minus x to the 3rd. So now we can rewrite p of x. I'll do it right over here. P of x is equal to x squared times q of x. It's equal to, no, that's not the same blue. It's equal to x squared times q of x plus this business plus q of x plus x squared plus 1. And then we have this last negative x, or last minus x right over there. Now, when we evaluate, if I say that r is a root, if r is a root of q, or if I write q of r is equal to 0, then what is p of r? P of r is going to be equal to x squared times q of r plus q of r plus r squared. I'll switch these. Minus r plus 1. So this is going to be 0, obviously. Q of r is 0. So this whole term is 0. This whole term is 0. So p of r is going to be equal to r squared minus r plus 1. Now, obviously, all of these guys are roots, so we can use that same logic. We can use that same logic. We can say p of, let me do a new color here. A new color is warranted. P of z1 is equal to z1 squared minus z1 plus 1. P of z2 is equal to z2 squared minus z2 plus 1. I'll go all four. P of z3 is equal to z3 squared minus z3 plus 1. And then finally, we have P of z4, and that's slightly different shade of orange, is z sub 4 squared minus z sub 4 plus 1. Now remember our problem. We just want to find the sum of these things. We just want to take the sum. So this sum is going to be the sum of these expressions. And you might be saying, Sal, we still don't know what these sums are. I could sum all the ones. I'll get a 4 there. But now I have to sum all the roots of q of x, and I have to sum all the squares of the roots of q of x. And this is not a simple thing. And frankly, it's not taught in most algebra classes or pre-calculus classes. This is a problem to really separate the people who study kind of quirky properties of polynomials from the people who don't study quirky properties of polynomials. But the last two videos I just recorded in the competition math playlist, and I actually added them to the algebra playlist as well, tell you how to find the sum of the roots of a polynomial or the sum of the squares of the roots of a polynomial. So let's think about this a little bit. So let's add up all the ones. That's easy. We get 4. Now, we're also going to have to add up all of, when you add up all of these guys over here, let me do this in a new color. When I add up all of these guys over here, it's going to be negative z1 plus z2 plus z3 plus z4. Now, two videos ago, I think it was, we showed that the sum of the roots of a polynomial, and this is the sum of the roots of q of x, that is equal to the negative of the coefficient on the second to highest degree term. Or I should say that, on the degree term that's one less than the highest degree term. So if we go to q of x, it's a fourth degree polynomial. The sum of the roots, to find the sum of the roots, we go one degree less than that. So we look for the third degree term. That's this over here. The coefficient on the third degree term over here is negative 1. It has a negative 1 coefficient. So the sum of the roots, this over here is going to be equal to the negative of that coefficient. So negative negative 1. So it's the negative of negative 1, which is just plus 1. And of course, we have a negative out front here. So this whole thing is going to evaluate to negative 1. So that whole business evaluates to negative 1. Now, we have to take the sum of the squares. We have to do all of this over here. The sum of z1 squared plus z2 squared plus z3 squared plus z4 squared. Now, in the last video where I talked about the sum of the squares, and I didn't prove it for the fourth degree case. It's actually pretty easy to extend it from the third degree case we did in that video to the fourth degree. And it's a little messy to do it generally, do the whole induction thing that I did with the straight up sum, not the sum of the squares. But hopefully you see or at least you understood how to apply it. And if you're interested, you actually could extend it to the fourth power, to the nth power. But this is going to be equal to the coefficient on, I should look at q of x, the coefficient on the degree 1 less than the highest degree. So it's going to be, so this is a negative 1. So it's going to be equal to negative 1 squared minus 2 times the coefficient on the degree below that. So minus 2 times the coefficient over here. We started at this degree. Now we're going even one lower than that, two lower than the degree of the polynomial. So we go to the x squared term. This coefficient is negative 1. So minus 2 times negative 1. This is equal to 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3. So this thing over here in green, when you take the sum of squares, it's equal to 3. And so when you take the total sum of p evaluated at each of those possibly complex numbers, we get 3 minus 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. And we're done.